Thank you so much, Caleb. Mr. Heyman, thank you for taking the time to speak with me. I just wanted to get your feelings on how well do you think Jimmy Uso and Solo Sikoa are going to fare against the mega tandem of LA Knight and John Cena?
Mega tandem. Where'd this name come from? It's stupid. Why would you say such a thing? A mega tandem? John Cena and LA Knight don't even like each other. They're a team based out of necessity. Necessity because they're targeted by the bloodline. Now, the bloodline, Jimmy Uso and Solo, they're brothers. They come from the same womb. They have the blood running through their veins, hence the name bloodline. John Cena and LA Knight are not a bloodline. They're people trying to survive against the bloodline, which means tonight, ladies and gentlemen, take it from the wise man, an easy victory tonight for Jimmy Uso and Solo of the bloodline.
Paul, but what if they lose?
What kind of question did they ask me? How can you ask me that question? What kind of stupid question is that? I'm going to answer a question about the bloodline losing to John Cena and LA Knight? I'm going to answer this question by a man dressed as a canary? Why would you ask me such a question? How could it possibly be? Why would you ask me the question? Why would they lose? No, really. See, what sense would it make for them to lose? Why would they lose? Why? Why? It makes no sense to ask me that. Could somebody please arrange for Kayla to interview me next time?
Wow.
My God, at least somebody with intelligence. I got a freaking canary asking stupid-ass questions about losing with the bloodline to LA Knight and John Cena.
Yeah. I know they're strong and big. Most importantly, somos dos mexicanos enojados.
Razón.
We got hard.
Yes.
Just let me ask you something. Is he coming through? Did he come through? And wait, just one more thing. If it comes to that, and you know it, lo sabes, if it's me and you against all of them, I don't care. I just want to know, did he come through?
So I placed the call yesterday, and I sent the text, and I know he read it, but he hasn't gotten back to me. Pero, es de confianza. Trust me, you'll come through, okay?
Well, are you an idiot? Is this your first time on the job? Look at her, she is the women's champion. She's a genius of this guy. She's a genius of this whole WWE. Locker room, okay? She's not gonna tell you her strategy, all right?
I got the baby. Mo daijoubu da kara. I have my own strategy. I don't need you tonight.
Well, Bailey, it seems like Io Sky's strategy is without you guys tonight.
Dougie,
yep.
Quack,
quack.
She was going to
be here.
Oh, wow. Beating the big man. Wow.
Man.
The superstar energy off the charts.
Jade Cargill and Triple H as I live and breathe. You kidding me?
What?
It's for the Undisputed WWE Tag Team Championship! Introducing first, from San Francisco, California, weighing in at 242 pounds, Main Event, Jay Uso! tag team partner from Atlanta, Georgia, weighing in at 222 pounds, the American Nightmare, Cody Rhodes.
What a unique gutbuster executed by Rhodes, and now letting all the blood rush to the head of Finn Balor.
And stalling vertical suplex by Cody Rhodes. Face first goes Balor. Ken Jay desperately trying to get to Cody, but a hand's length away. Ken Jay, create some space and get to Cody. And trying to get there, not quite. Another right hand by Jay. Balor still hanging on. Now a fingertip away. Cody's close. Priest knocked off the apron. Nobody home for Balor. Uso's got an opportunity.
Uso also has the entire distance of the ring to travel to tag the American Nightmare.
Tag! Here's Rhodes! And the Gainbridge Fieldhouse explodes for the entrance of Cody Rhodes. And Cody, nice power slam. Disaster kick. Now he hooks Balor for crossroads. Balor turns it around, however.
Cody counters again.
Cody from the second rope, went for the Cody cutter block by Balor. Finn Balor going up to the top rope, looking for the coup de grace, but Cody Rhodes able to counter.
Rough landing for Finn on top of the ring post. May have jammed his tailbone, but still no shortage of fight left in the Irishman.
And now both these men exchanging blows. Cody Rhodes, though, hooking Balor from way up high above the ring.
Oh, look at this power from the American Nightmare. My goodness.
Superplex.
It's not the fall that hurts, it's the sudden stop at the end.
And now, Damian Priest in a position for the razor's edge. Jey Uso in all kinds of trouble. Middle of the ring, Jey though slips underneath, catches Balor with a right hand. And Priest up over the top rope to the floor.
Main event, Jey.
And Uso, incoming. Priest and Balor into the announce table. And Damian Priest's eyes rolled into the back of his head as he hit the table hard.
Balor's still down. Jey Uso has a golden opportunity from the top.
Uso splash. Cover. And Finn Balor saves the championship.
My goodness. We're going to take a ride south of heaven.
Not quite. Jey Uso able to slip out. Uso with a spear.
Ooh.
A spear by Jey Uso. The move used by the head of the table, the tribal chief, Roman Reigns, who returns to SmackDown Friday night. And Jey Uso perhaps a little message. And look who's here. Rhea Ripley, who is establishing herself as the leader of the Judgment Day, face to face with Jey Uso. There have been some tension between the two as of late.
Acknowledge him.
Uso cannot afford to be tempted by this succubus, Rhea Ripley. Priest now, high risk
Tag. Situation.
Oh, God!
Damian Priest with a Hurricane Rana may have hurt his knee. Meanwhile, Balor, coup de grace!
That's gonna do it. That's the dagger.
Judgment Day to retain. Cody Rhodes saves the matchup. Roll up by Uso for the gold. Oh, no! Ripley with the Money in the Bank briefcase in the face of Jey Uso. Jey kicks out.
What? But look at Priest.
Oh, no, a choke slam on the apron to Rhodes.
What a competitor Damian Priest is. Fighting out through the pain.
Damian Priest ripping apart our announce table. Looking to do even more damage with Ripley and McDonough and Dominic get out here. It's a 5-on-2 for Judgment Day. Oh! McDonough with a briefcase to the bad knee of Priest!
Did you see how Damian's knee buckled? No.
Crossroads! On the table! Tag! Super kick! Double team! Cody Cutter!
Here are your winners! And the new Undisputed WWE Tag Team Champions! Main event, Jey Uso and the American Nightmare, Cody Rhodes!
Corey, what a wild ending to that match!
This was incredible. What a shocking turn of events.
The Judgment Day had a 5-on-2 situation before things imploded.
What a way to start Fastlane.
Yeah, kickoff show was great, but I'm so excited about the main event.
Oh,
yeah. And the rest of the show, it's going to be great.
Let me ask you this. Who is going to be crazy enough to tag with the LWO against Bobby Lashley and the Street Profits?
Can't tell you, man, but the show is already kicking off like Fastlane, man.
Oh, it's been nasty so far. Ah, you mind if I chill in here? Watch the rest of the show with y'all? Come on.
I mean, yeah,
in here. Come on, with the legend and the legend himself, two legends.
I'm a legend.
Yeah. All right, perfect. Because I was actually about to order some off the Pizza Hut.
Pizza?
Come on, baby.
Did you say pizza?
You know I did. Personally, I'm biased to the stuffed, crust, pepperoni, and bacon. But, you know, I can get a big dinner box so everybody can have some. Well, where are you going?
I like that.
We got you back in.
I like that.
There we go. All right, cool. Well, since I'm ordering off the app, you know it'll be here hot and fast.
I'm afraid I've got some bad news.
Come on, man.
What?
You know what? Even I don't have bad news. I love me some Pizza Hut.
There we go. See, that's good news right there. Yeah. You know why? Because no one out pizzas the Hut.
Yeah.
Well, let's get some stuff. Yeah. What's going on?
Can we get some breadsticks?
Breadsticks?
Can we get some wings?
Wings?
All of that.
Yep. Some pepperoni and sausage.
Bobby Lashley said, I don't care who Rey Mysterio calls. It's going to be a long night. You cannot stop the inevitable.
I don't know. This is going to be a very long night because I see the Street Profits and Bobby Lashley looking like three hungry lions ready to feast.
3-2.
And Montez Ford getting a bit cocky in the early going in the 3-on-2 situation at Santos Escobar.
I think Escobar could be a future champion here in WWE in the near future.
Had a great United States Championship matchup a couple of weeks ago against his mentor, Rey Mysterio.
I think Escobar has all the potential in the world.
And Escobar, the second generation star. Montez Ford quickly dropped out to the apron. And again, laughing at and mocking Santos Escobar. And again, Montez Ford getting a bit cocky, and it's cost him in the early going.
And I think it's perfectly acceptable to be cocky when you're as talented as Ford, but it's a little early in the matchup.
Well, it's also a little early in the relationship with Bobby Lashley to be making mistakes. And look at that!
Wow.
Hurricane Rana by Escobar. The height to Ford. Cover for the win. Bobby Lashley breaking things up. And Bobby's done playing around. Ooh, Ray. Into the turnbuckle hard. Mysterio, though, his quickness.
Oh.
Into the post, shoulder first is Lashley. Ford now sent over the top rope. And Mysterio looking to build a little bit of momentum here.
Ray was so disoriented after the beatdown, he was crawling toward the wrong corner. Tag made, Dawkins better hurry.
And Dawkins doing a great job not allowing Mysterio to get over to Santos Escobar, at least momentarily. Ray creates some space, tag. Oh no!
Beautiful!
Montez Ford ripping Escobar off the apron, driving him into the barricade.
That was main event level ring awareness by Montez Ford. Realizing the circumstance and doing what he needed to do in the heat of the moment.
Oh, Zelina Vega made the cocky Ford pay. A meteora by Vega.
That should be a disqualification. She's not a legal competitor in this match.
And Rey Mysterio now with a DDT plants Dawkins.
And now Ford hoisting Mysterio up. Ray trying to fight back. Couple of well-placed knees to the face. Mysterio now to the enziguri. Caught Montez Ford back of the neck. Drives him out of the ring.
And yet again, Lashley tasked with helping Ford recover on the outside.
Zelina Vega begging for Mysterio to make it.
You know what cool is?
Rey Mysterio's got backup. I guess his phone call was answered. It's Carlito. Carlito's here.
I'm just talking about bad apples. This one might flatten the bunch.
And Carlito now taking out Montez Ford. Bobby Lashley takes a right hand.
And there's no way in hell that Ford or Dawkins or Lashley could have prepared for Carlito.
Carlito telegraphed that. Montez Ford now runs into a drop kick by Caribbean Cool Carlito. Off the kip up. Carlito looks great.
In tremendous physical condition.
Mysterio takes out Dawkins with a seated senton. Escobar drives Lashley into the barricade.
Did you order a pizza?
I didn't.
Well, I know it wasn't Wade Barrett because he's as cheap as they come. So, but anyway, this looks like one of those big dinner boxes. And it smells pretty. Hey, Woods! What's up?
You know, if we had a pizza in the back, you guys are out here working hard tirelessly. So I figured you need some pizza too. So I went ahead and got to a big dinner box. Take a look, baby.
Yeah!
Baby!
Oh, breadsticks?
Wow, man.
Can we try some?
Pepperoni, please.
Oh, look at the pepperoni.
Please, I'm going to take a look myself.
French is going to be upset.
Make over, Claw. I mean.
No one not pleases the hunt, Michael. You know.
The miss!
A miss by Oscar!
Smart!
And Charlotte now back in the play with a big boot. And EO.
Fences her into a crossface.
In the center of the ring. Remember, submission will retain the championship for EO Sky.
Unfortunately for EO, it's going to take a lot longer to force the queen to submit, if at all.
Oh, what a kick by Asuka.
Now the champion making the climb to the top.
Top rope now, Asuka.
No one in this matchup as comfortable in the air as EO Sky, but Asuka looking to rip the champion down.
EO drops Asuka back into the ring, trying to make it to the top rope. Asuka's gonna meet her there. Oh my goodness, German suplex released.
What on earth is the queen looking to do here?
Maybe a double suplex, but EO and Asuka able to counter. Charlotte, though, turns it around. Great power by Charlotte.
Now the champion with an opportunity to impress.
EO set across the ring, out of the ring, and it into Charlotte. Charlotte have in mind here. EO top rope now on the shoulders of Charlotte Flair. Charlotte now powering the champion up. Asuka now into the mix.
Oh dear. Oh dear.
Oh my goodness! Cover by Asuka to win the championship. And now. And now Asuka and Charlotte, spear! Bayley's here. Bayley trying to revive EO Sky.
You gotta get on Bayley, get in there.
Because Bayley truly is what she says she is.
You okay? You okay?
Bayley is a role model. Bayley is a friend and a mentor to EO Sky.
chicken wing for the first part of this Asuka lock, but is instead met with a figure four yet again.
And look at a bridge. Charlotte, can she bridge into the figure eight? And Bayley knows what the figure eight's all about. And
there it is.
Now there's the bridge. Bayley up on the apron. Bayley into the ring. There are no disqualifications.
Hey, let's go.
I was hoping he was going to make it tonight. We are in Indianapolis, the home of Pat McAfee.
I was hoping he fell into the Red River.
I wasn't sure if he was going to make it here, though, Corey, because he's had quite the day. College game day at the Texas State Fair, alternate broadcast of the Red River rivalry, and now he's wearing one of the NFL legacy belts of his Indianapolis Colts.
This guy has never met a spotlight he didn't like. McAfee this morning was standing in line for the opening of a refrigerator.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Pat McAfee!
All-decade punter right here in Indianapolis for the Colts.
There was no chance in hell I was going to miss this show on this night in this glorious city. We all know it when we see it as members of the WWE universe. The WWE will come to a town and the crowd won't appreciate the fact that the WWE's there. The crowd stinks. They have no energy. They have no life. They have no juice. That's not Indianapolis, Indiana. I think Indianapolis, Indiana has deserved a WrestleMania. I think they heard you in the back. Let's make them feel it a little bit. If you think Indianapolis should host a WrestleMania, give me a hell yeah. Before I go sit down with the greatest of all time, Michael Cole, in that hating ass Corey Graves.
Hating ass.
Allow me to introduce a man who's a 16-time world champion. A man who will be tag teaming tonight with
L.A.
Ladies and gentlemen, John Cena.
California, weighing 240 pounds, L.A. Knight!
Welcome back, partner. I'm I'm surprised he made it all the way up from Texas in the Red River Rivalry.
The state you call home is certainly beautiful. I got third-degree burns, and the game was fantastic. But this night, I had to experience live. God, Cole, it's great to be back with you.
I spoke to LA Knight earlier today, and he told me, guys, that this is indeed the biggest match of his life. The opportunity to team up with John Cena on this grand stage against the Bloodline. He understands what this means.
This truly has the potential to be a make or break matchup for LA Knight regarding the future of his WWE career, but it may be the hardest task of his entire life.
Anytime you get to team up with a GOAT, you're gonna learn some stuff too. So whatever happens tonight is gonna help LA Knight in the future. And we got a Cena start to this match, Cole.
16-time world champion. I've dubbed him the greatest of all time, and I firmly believe that. John Cena against Jimmy Uso of the Bloodline. It's interesting to Cena and Solo Sikoa go face to face. John Cena is gonna be on NXT this Tuesday night in the corner of Carmelo Hayes. Paul Heyman's gonna be there in the corner of Braun Breaker for that massive matchup Tuesday night. Oh, Solo drops Cena.
Right now, it's Solo Sikoa who's got that dog in him.
I'll tell you what, it's kind of weird for me to look up there and see him and not put my finger to the sky with him. He's completely changed. And what if he's not in the Bloodline? He did all this turnery.
And you're right. That's a very real risk that Jimmy's dealing with. He may not be back in the good graces of the Tribal Chief.
Turnery.
Oh, and Cena is just being beaten to a pulp here.
Did you learn that in mathematics class?
Yeah, I am not a mathematician. I mean, Cena's really been getting his ass kicked here. Happy to hear Indianapolis is rallying behind him.
And Jimmy Uso now just trash-talking LA Knight.
LA Knight's got to be getting a little bit upset out there.
How patiently waiting to try to get into this match. Cena!
Oh!
AA! Attitude adjustment from out of nowhere! But Cena, can he capitalize? Is this LA Knight's opportunity? Is this LA Knight's moment? Cena gets there! Here comes Knight! Jimmy Uso legal as well!
Yeah!
And the self-proclaimed megastar!
Yeah!
The fastest rising star in WWE! The Covenant with a swinging neck breaker! Solo knocked off the apron!
LA Knight is on fire!
And so is the WWE Universe here in Indianapolis! DDT! Looking for the Uso splash. LA Knight rolls out of harm's way. And Knight scoops up Uso, plants him.
The poor wise man sweating bullets out here.
Big elbow by LA Knight.
Here comes Solo again. What the hell is Cena doing?
Oh, and a Samoan drop. Cena to the top rope.
Teammate.
Cross body. Uso splash!
It's also an honor to watch LA Knight work as he's battling with the Bloodline.
Cena has taken so much punishment in this match tonight. It's electrifying.
Look at this.
I love
a man that can throw both hands.
Ambidextrous, yes.
Much to the delight of the WWE fans.
Oh!
Over the top. John Cena from behind. Solo Sikoa. Super kick by Jimmy Uso.
Caught him on the button, I do believe.
And now Jimmy Uso looking to put Cena away. Meanwhile, back in the ring, LA Knight, Solo Sikoa. Solo goes up over the top rope. LA Knight now, he's gonna meet Jimmy Uso up top. That looks familiar.
That's awesome.
LA Knight now with a superplex. Cena with a classic vintage five knuckle shuffle.
I mean, I don't think tonight's the night, man. Your legs hurt, I'm banged up. I won't be out there to support you. Let's just take a chill pill, relax.
No,
guys! What happened, happened. I'm not going home empty-handed. It has to be tonight.
Priest, not tonight. Priest, look at yourself. You're the one that said you didn't want to rush this. You said that you wanted to be ready, and you're not. Hey! We'll do it another night, but tonight's not it. Briefcase. Rest up.
Come on, man. Take a weight off. Sit down. Rest up, leg.
For the first time in Seth Rollins' storied career, he will participate in a last man standing match.
We talked about this back last month at Payback, Corey, the fact that Seth Rollins just really survived that night. And Al Nakamura got what he wanted. Seth Rollins, though, to Corey's point, trying to end things early. Steel steps in hand, smile on his face. Nakamura in a prone position. And now the steps driven right into the side of Nakamura.
We talked about their last encounter. When you're talking about a veteran, a world-traveled champion, such as Shinsuke Nakamura.
Oh, goodness.
If you're anything less than 100% and the stakes are this high, you need to look for the walk-off early. You want to go home, live to fight another day as champion.
Rollins has made his way as champion since May of this year when he won the inaugural World Heavyweight Championship Tournament. Again, all this is legal in a last man standing match. The unpredictable, the ever-evolving Seth Rollins going to use everything at his disposal to put Nakamura away.
Taking things to the extreme seems to be something of a family business these days.
Yeah, right.
Last Saturday night, Becky Lynch did it, and Rollins just up in the ante already. Are those nunchucks?
Nakamura, the martial arts expert. Nunchucks in hand.
Oh, no.
Seth Rollins with a garbage can and right to the leg of Rollins, dropping Seth Rollins, and now Nakamura on display again to Seth.
With Nakamura knotting up the hamstring of the world heavyweight champion.
Out of the back. Out of the back of Rollins.
Make no mistake about it, in spite of his back injury, Rollins, one of the best physically conditioned athletes in the world. Incredible cardio, incredible stamina.
And then the running knee.
And what we are seeing now is the true Shinsuke Nakamura.
And Nakamura, into the table. The table bent but did not break.
Shinsuke had designs on delivering an
and a stop! Stop by Rollins! Rollins near the top of the ladder!
Oh, Shinsuke out of the way just in time. Seth's passion second to none, as evidenced by the fact he is
willing to put himself through physical hell for the prestigious World Heavyweight Championship. Seth promised to be a fighting champion, and boy, has he lived up to that promise thus far.
And now Rollins, right into that barrier there by Nakamura. Fighting over on the edge of the stands near the technical area. And
face first off of the unforgiving road case. And what on earth is Nakamura cooking up now?
Well, anything he wants to. Playing on the edge of the stairs, on the edge of the WWE fans here in Indianapolis. Nakamura continues to climb higher with Seth Rollins in tow. This is for the World Heavyweight Championship, held by Seth Rollins. Last man standing. No pinfall, submission, countouts or disqualifications. The only way you win. Oh, and
Rollins is really making use of the fact that there is no disqualification.
And oh, and a low blow.
And Rollins, oh no!
Oh my goodness. Did you see Rollins' body buckle? And this has just been a methodical beatdown from Shinsuke Nakamura. Eerie, scary.
Oh! Rollins just avoided disaster. Uh-oh.
Now on the concrete, Seth Rollins was looking for a pedigree. Oh my God! And now Joel driven.
Just that quick.
Spine first into the apron again by Nakamura. And now Shinsuke Nakamura teeing off and finding a second win. And the WWE fans trying to rally Seth Rollins here in Indianapolis.
I don't know what Shinsuke's thinking, but if he lands this, we're going to have ourselves a new champion.
And mocking the WWE fans who are singing Rollins.
Oh, my God!
Double knees through the ribs. He may have a busted back. He may have broken ribs. And Rollins dragging Nakamura back to the Corey. You know this man for 10 years. Talk some damn sense.
What the hell am I supposed to tell
him? Get him off the damn ladder.
Seth, what are you doing?
You're gonna kill yourself.
Oh no. Nakamura now.
And Nakamura back now to the other end of the table. Rollins climbing even higher.
Seth, don't. No. This is gonna end two careers.
Rollins trying to somehow superplex Nakamura. Oh no! Nakamura with the mist! And Rollins to the double!
Kinshasa!
Through the table that buries Rollins. And Nakamura now trying to lift Seth Rollins up and put Rollins away once and for all. Rollins fights back with an elbow. And now Seth Rollins hooks up Shinsuke Nakamura for a pedigree.
How in the hell is Rollins finding the will
absolutely
to fight on?
No idea. Seth Rollins delivering a pedigree, fighting himself back in this match with the World Heavyweight Champion.